yes, this is Top Hat John. We are at the Gratiot Cruise, the Clinton Township Cruise. This is the 15th annual. We got good cars. We got the kids with the little paddy wagons, too. They're going to be doing that race. We're at the 15th cruise. We've got a lot of stuff, a lot of cars. We're going to have a lot of fun again today up and down the avenue, stopping at some of the sponsors. And right now, let me introduce you to none other than Township Supervisor, Mr. Bob Cannon.
Hi, I'm Bob Cannon, your Township Supervisor, and with me are two of my trustees, Ken Pearl and Joe Aragona. Now, Ken, you and I have been doing this for quite some time. You've been on the board for 9 years now, and you've been with me every one of those 9 years, going in the opening lap and then walking up and down Gratiot. What changes have you noticed?
Oh, this year it seems like I went down there earlier and there's more tents set up, more private parties, there's more car shows, you know, and you and I decided to go on the committee itself, so we're more involved. So we've moved the Midway, everything. Now the Parks and Rec group is down at the Midway with all the games, and that should make it a little easier, and there's more parking over there now.
It seems like it's going to be real nice. And Joe, this is your first time out. What have you noticed so far?
Well, I usually come at night on Gratiot Cruise night, but this time we're here in the morning, and the atmosphere is absolutely electrifying. People are bringing their cars. They're loving it. There are some absolutely gorgeous cars already out at what time is it, about 10 a.m. in the morning? This is fantastic.
I went down about 7:30 up and down the boulevard, and people were setting up their tents and their cars just for today.
Mm-hmm.
And Ken, we've seen it grow. It started very small. You weren't on the board when it first started, but there were a few parties going on, customer appreciation parties, and then there were employee appreciation parties, but now it seems like every other business has something.
Yeah, I drove down this morning early, and there's, like I said, there's people setting up tents. There's people already in chairs waiting.
Our grand marshals today, all three of you. Tracy, this is the first time you've been to this cruise, isn't it?
It is, actually, yes.
And we're very excited about that. And Mr. Hackle, you have been here, I think, every cruise we've ever had.
Yes, and I enjoy it. I tell you, for some reason, it always seems to be good weather. So I don't know if that's your call, Bob, or not, but I'm going to assume it is. So.
No, it's not my call. We do a lot of praying ahead of time. And Jeffrey, you have ridden in the parade, too, haven't you?
Yes, this is my second time in this parade.
That's good. When you got the call to be the grand marshals, were you surprised?
I was, actually. So, and very excited to accept the offer as well.
And I got to tell you, Gary Broad, who owns this vehicle here, is the guy that is going to be driving us. He's a great guy, a person that lives in the township, as a matter of fact, and is always giving of his time. And obviously, financially, he's very generous. So we're glad to be with him. He's a friend of ours. And boy, so once again, a beautiful day for a great event.
It's a great day. There's going to be a lot of people. They expect about 200,000 people on the route. Not when we go, because not everybody's
right.
All set up.
Right.
But there will be that many people here today.
Yeah, that's what I told Tracy. I said, be ready. Your parade wave, you know, I don't know if you practice it.
I didn't practice it, so we'll see how it goes.
Okay. It'll be fun. Again, thank you for volunteering, and I know that you were a little disappointed that you were number two to Eminem, but
that's okay. Marshall, if I got to be second fiddle to Marshall Mathers, I'm all right with that.
Yeah,
I can handle it.
You take everything in great spirit and great stride. So, again, thank you especially, Tracy.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yes. Nice to do this, Bob.
It's our pleasure.
Thank you.
Meltzer, Clinton Township Clerk. I'm here with Tony Wickersham, our County Sheriff. And Tony, thank you for being out here. You're always out here to enjoy this wonderful event. Today is a beautiful day. It's a little overcast, which is nice. We don't have that too much heat. Tell us, why are you guys here? I know that I see the support that you've given the township over the years. Tell us what you guys do here for the township during the cruise.
You know, to start off, this is kind of the anchor event here in Clinton Township. And again, the cruise is a great event, and it draws a lot of people to the township and to Macomb County. From the sheriff's perspective, you know, we work with Clinton Township Police Department. They do a great job out here with the traffic control and the pedestrian traffic. And again, the sheriff's deputies, along with our reserves, we help them out throughout the event. So it's just law enforcement working together, and it's on a daily basis. We all help each other out. We don't believe in the geographical boundaries. We're all in it to the safety of our citizens.
We see that, you know, and we have never heard any problems at all between our Clinton Township Police Department and Macomb County Sheriff's. We know that any situations that are going on, you guys are working together to make this community safe and better, and we just so appreciate you being out here representing this great event. It's a great moneymaker for the township, a good shot economically in the arm, and that can translate into helping and supporting our police and our Sheriff's Department, and people want to see you out here. They love to know that the police officers and sheriffs are working to keep us safe. So thank you so much for
what you do. And let's hope for a great event.
It's going to be a great one.
It's good.
On the 15th anniversary of the Gratiot Cruise here in Clinton Township, we're at the spot we started 15 years ago, the corner of 16 Mile and Gratiot, which is owned by McLaren Macomb, which is headed now by Tom Brissy. Tom, you're a car guy.
I am a car guy. I love all old cars. In fact, I have my 74 Stingray right behind us.
I remember introducing you to somebody that owns a car dealership, and he had a few old cars in his back room, and I think we went there for a lunch or something, and we ended up spending the whole day.
We did. What a great day. We were at Chuck Riley's looking at all his old Corvettes, and they were all beautiful. As you can tell, I'm a Corvette guy.
You are a Corvette guy. But even better than that, your company has been a sponsor from the very beginning. You know, why do you sponsor events like this?
Well, we like to be part of the community. We, you know, the community comes to our hospital in times of need. It's nice to be involved for the fun times as well. We have a premier piece of property here that is a great place to host the parade and host the headquarters for the Clinton Township Gratiot Cruise, so it's just a natural for us.
It fits well with us too, and you're very hospitable. You're offering a breakfast today for all the workers and the people that have helped make this a big success, so thanks for doing that also.
You're welcome. We're happy to do it, and happy to have everybody come onto our property and get to know us a little better.
We like that. Thanks for the service you provide to our community. You went from a sleepy little hospital to a little bit bigger hospital to now a hospital that people come regionally for service.
Yep. When we became a level 2 trauma center, it changed the face of our hospital. We're working it hard, as you know, on a project to raise some money to build a new tower, which will include a brand new emergency center. That's going to be another game changer in the evolution of our hospital.
And the other thing that I notice is you have a lot of great doctors on your staff, and you even are part of Carmanos now.
We are. Carmanos is part of the McLaren family. We have 11 other hospitals across the state of Michigan, and just getting bigger and better every day.
Well, thanks for what you do here in Clinton Township and Macomb County, and actually the three-county region.
You're welcome. It's our pleasure.
Our Clinton Township firefighters, and they're at the Dorian Midway. You want to tell us what you guys are doing here today for the kids?
Yeah, thank you. Just today, we're at Dorian, just handing out, you know, free helmets and fire safety things and packets and stuff like that. We've got some t-shirts and stuff that for $10 donations and things like that. Just out here with the public, just, you know, trying to give back a little bit.
Now, I noticed some of the kids are getting their pictures taken in the truck. That's got to be a big deal.
Yeah, that's a pretty cool thing. You know, it's nice the kids, they'll get pretty excited about it, and it, you know, it just lets them know, kind of like, you know, we're here to help.
Maybe future recruits.
Yeah, maybe. We'll see. You know, it's possible.
You want to tell us a little bit about this truck? I know this isn't a standard fire truck. What is this vehicle?
This is our rescue truck, RRTN. This is actually one of our reserve rigs. Typically, this rig will be used if we have to send our ladder truck, which is at headquarters there at Station 4, out for repairs. We'll put this rig in service, you know, if it's general maintenance to the other rigs. So this one isn't manned 24 hours a day. It's one of our reserve apparatuses that we have, just in case it needs to be utilized.
You guys got some new trucks a while ago. How are you working out?
Yeah, we got five new engines from HME. They're working out really well. They're good pieces of equipment, good machinery. So it's nice. They're nice rigs to have.
Now, basically a standard pumper truck, what's the normal lifespan?
Typically, I would say anywhere from 10 to 15 years, I think, is what NFPA says. I couldn't, I'm 100% sure on it, but I think about 10 or 15 years.
Even though they're a little expensive, they last.
Yeah, they're quality built, they last, yep. I mean, you know, we try to do our due diligence to take care of them, stuff like that as well. So, you know, keep them around as long as we can.
We're at Dorian Midway right now with Andrea Irons. Andrea, you want to tell us a little bit about the Dorian Midway?
Yes. At the Midway this year, we have the Kids Zone. We have Clinton Township Parks and Recs that set up the bounce houses and games for kids to play. We also have some vendors that are doing some giveaways. McLaren is giving out bike helmets. They're fitting the bike helmets for kids. We've got food trucks this year. We've got El Charro, Marconi's Pizza, Goat Cheese, and Crepe de Trois. We also have Aloha Ice. We've got the fire department here giving out stuff for the kids. Police mobile command units here. We've got a great crowd so far. It's still early, so hopefully we'll get some more people down here at the Dorian Ford Midway today.
Once in a while, you get to see somebody from another part of the country that's here in Michigan because of all the cool cruises we do. None other than Mr. Robert Roxy from Gilbert, Arizona. Bob, how are you today?
Great. Beautiful day out here.
You know, my very first car was a 1955 Chevrolet Bel Air two-door sedan. So, I kind of like these cars a little bit, and this fire engine red, pretty cool.
Yeah, it makes it pop. Definitely gets some attention.
Well, when you and I were talking, you told me that you did live in Michigan, and then you moved to Arizona?
I'm born and raised here. I'm a true Michigan person, and, you know, winter got to me, and in 94 I moved out, but my heart's still here. I had to come back.
Yeah, but there ain't nothing wrong with being somewhere where there's no angel puke.
Exactly. But you still miss it here. Still love this place.
Yeah, I spent 3 months in Florida and a month in Arizona, and I loved it. And as I had told you before, Tombstone was my absolute favorite town. It's a great state. Love Arizona,
yes.
Fabulous scenery. But Tombstone was great. I got to meet Wyatt Earp. When you were in Michigan, what did you do here?
Oh, we went to, all week long, the Gratiot Cruise had a stop every night, and we hit that. A little bit of rain one night, but I don't care. I had to be here, you know, wanted to experience it all. And, you know, just going up and down Gratiot is just awesome.
When did you move out to Arizona?
In 1994.
Wow, that's last century.
Yeah,
that's
I know.
That's a couple of weeks ago. What have you been doing in Arizona?
I do classic cars out there.
Really?
I fix them up, put them together and buy, sell them a little bit and basically enjoy them.
Next time I'm out there, we'll have to look you up. What a difference. You don't have any kind of rot or rust with Arizona stuff.
No.
Is this an Arizona car?
This is a true Arizona car. It has all the original panels on it, all the steel panels, floor, and everything is all still original to the car.
Tell me a little bit about the motor. What's in here?
It's a Eldebrock crate motor 350, aluminum heads, aluminum manifold, Eldebrock carb, headers, power steering, power brakes, and of course, Arizona, we have air conditioning.
Absolutely. I see you got the sanded pump on it, so
yeah.
It's great having all that. What about a transmission that you're driving?
700R. We'll run
beautiful.
Got to have that overdrive.
What's the gear in the back?
Yeah, 305.
Holy smokes. So you can be doing 100 at about 2,000 RPM.
Yeah. Yep.
Beautiful. Well, it's really neat to see you here. Cool car. I love Arizona. We spent a lot of time in Gilbert, Arizona. That's right by the drag strip, right close by. Do you get to race at all?
Oh, yeah. Firebird Raceway, for sure.
Great place, and they still have the liquid quarter mile?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Used to love racing boats out there.
Oh, everything. Yep.
Well, you enjoy the cruising. Good seeing you.
Great. Thank you very much.
Bob Roxy, Gilbert, Arizona. At the Gratiot Cruise.
Next to me is Denise Caldwell. This is a lady racer. Denise, you want to tell us a little bit about this monster?
Oh, this monster is something. It's a 1965 Dodge Coronet A990. It's a Hemi car. It's really super stock, beautiful car.
This is a real A990.
It's not real. It was built as a tribute car. We found as many real parts as we could. We traveled all over the eastern United States, got a lot of parts in Pennsylvania, but put it together just as it would have come off the assembly line.
Now, what are we talking horsepower? I know this isn't stock.
It is not stock. We have about 666. We had it dynoed, and it's pretty stout. We stroked it and got a little bit more horsepower out of it.
I noticed when it was coming in, it had a whole lot more horsepower. Who did the paint on it?
The paint was done by Brian Westbrook. It was East River Rides. He was a friend of ours who had his own body shop. And boy, did he do a magnificent job. He made it straight and pretty and put the beautiful flash red paint on it.
Now, you guys are from Ohio?
Yes, we are. About 45 minutes east of Cleveland.
So you came to this show from Ohio?
Yes, we did. Yes, we did. We met Tom Tignelli a while back, and he found out about this show and said, we're coming up. So that's why we're here.
I'm here with John Perino, the president of one of the local Corvette clubs. John, you want to give us a little information about your club?
Yeah, we're the Eastside Corvette Club Detroit. I formed it as a club for just the East Side, since most of the clubs, the Corvette clubs, were on the West Side. So we have about 38 members right now, and we're growing. But we're just a small club. We don't have any dues or any meetings. We're just a fun group of people who like to get together and do things together, like cruises, rides, dinners, things like that.
Now, you guys also meet every Monday night at Lakeside, right?
Yes, at the Great Lakes restaurant there at Lakeside, in front of Cole's restaurant.
It looks like you got a pretty good turnout here today.
Yeah, we do. So it's not just me. Some of these people belong to a group called the Macomb Posse. That's just another local group, not exactly a club per se, but they're a local group that hang together too. So it's them and a lot of just Corvette aficionados who've stopped by.
Okay, great. Now, if you come out to Lakeside, you got the Mustang Club, the Corvette Club, and everybody else.
That's right. It's a lot of fun up there.
John, thank you.
Thank you.
You enjoyed our cruise, all the coverage that we have. We'd like to thank all of the wonderful people from Clinton Township, the police department that did such a great job of keeping everything smooth and the traffic flowing for us, all of our sponsors, all the automobiles, and all the people that have worked so hard to make this event as much fun as it is. It's a great family show. Thank you, Clinton Township. I'm happy to be here. Have a wonderful time the rest of the day. Enjoy the program. See ya.